Finally, the vaccine rollout has started. When are you getting your vaccines?
No way! I am not getting any vaccine. You never know about what conspiracies these big pharmaceutical companies be part of.
Really? Are you an anti-vaxxer?
I prefer being called a skeptic.
A skeptic is the one who asks questions and finds answer to them.
Exactly.
So what do you know? How do vaccines work?
That's simple. They put chip in your body, which can track your location, where are you all the time.
What's there in your hand?
Oh, that's just my mobile. What's your point?
Come with me. You really need to know how vaccines work.
Hey, Karthik! How much money did Bill Gates give you?
Germs are all around us, and an encounter with the harmful ones can lead to disease and even death. These disease-causing organisms are called pathogens. Usually our skin, mucus and or cilia work as physical barriers to prevent these harmful germs from entering our body. But if a pathogen still somehow manages to affect the body, it becomes the job of our body's inner defenses. Think of antibodies as soldiers in the immune system's army. Each soldier is trained to fight a specific antigen. We have thousands of antibodies in our bodies.
Antibodies in our bodies? What a statement.
And produce specific antibodies to tackle it when it is exposed to it for the first time. In the meantime, the person is basically defenseless. And more often than not, the pathogen manages to multiply itself enough before the body can recognize its antigen. But once it wins a fight, it keeps the memory of the enemy. As along with producing antibodies, it also creates antibody-producing memory cells. Now the body is ready to fight the pathogen the second it enters your body.
Yeah. But what has vaccine got to do with all of this?
Well, that is basically the concept that vaccines follow. Vaccines contain weakened or inactive parts of a particular organism that trigger an immune response within the body. This weakened version will not cause the disease in the person receiving the vaccine, but it will prompt their immune system to respond as it would have to the actual pathogen. There are different types of vaccines. Let's look at some of them. Live attenuated vaccines. In live attenuated vaccine, a weaker virus or bacteria is injected into the body. Because it is a weak pathogen, it will not spread or cause sickness. Unless you have a really weakened immune system. What it does is that it allows the immune system to learn to recognize the antigens of the pathogen so that it can quickly decide to fight it in the future if it enters the body. You can say that it provides a simulation or training exercise for the immune system so that it can recognize its enemies. These vaccines have to be refrigerated all time so that the weak pathogen doesn't die. Measles, mumps, rotavirus and influenza are some examples of the vaccines that use this method. Inactivated vaccines. In these type of vaccines, the pathogen is first killed with heat or chemicals, then its dead cells are injected in the body. This is the safest vaccine possible. A dead virus or bacteria can make you sick, but it can still help the body learn from its antigens, so as to know to fight the live version of it in the future. They can be kept refrigerated or dried and stored as there is no risk of killing the pathogen. But because the virus or bacteria is dead, it does not provide an accurate training exercise for the immune system and may require multiple shots before the body actually learns to defend itself. Polio, rabies, or hepatitis A vaccines are some of the examples. Subunit vaccines. As technology has advanced, we are now able to isolate specific proteins or carbohydrates, that is, specific antigens of a pathogen, which when injected inside the body can help train the immune system without risking sickness, as only a part of the original bacteria or virus is used and not the whole. But it is not easy to identify the best antigens in a pathogen that can train the immune system, and even when identified, separating them is not always possible. Hepatitis B is an example of this type of vaccine. Toxoid vaccines. Some pathogens damage the body by secreting harmful toxins or chemicals in the blood. scientists are now able to deactivate part of the toxins using a mixture of chemicals and water. The dead toxins are then injected in the body, which helps the immune system learn from the dead toxins to fight off living toxins when the time comes. Diphtheria or tetanus vaccines are some of the examples. Conjugate vaccines. Some bacteria, like of the HIV disease, form an outer coating of sugar molecules that hide their antigens, fooling the immune system. To get around the problem, scientists connect an already known antigen from another known pathogen to the sugary coating. So the body learns to recognize the sugar coating itself as harmful and immediately attacks it if it enters the body. DNA vaccines. These are the newest type of vaccines and are still in the experimental stage. They could allow us to do away with all the unnecessary parts of the pathogen by injecting just a few parts of the pathogen's DNA. As a result, these would be very efficient immune system trainers and are also cheap and easy to produce. Most vaccines in this category are still in the human testing phases.
So now, will you get vaccinated?
I don't know. It's too much effort. I think my immunity is already strong.
Well, that's not the right approach.
Hey, do your work, man.
Do like the video if you liked it. Share it with your friends and family. And subscribe to the channel Thought Control.
Thank you so much, guys. And please don't be responsible. Go and get yourself vaccinated once it is open for all. Thank you so much. Bye-bye, Tata.
Thank you for watching the video. If you have any specific regards...
Yeah. But what has vaccine got to do with all this?